In this video, we're going to finish with the third declension noun, and then we're going to look at a new verb, the verb aimi.
Nominative, plural, third declension masculine and feminine nouns end in epsilon sigma, epsilon sigma. Neuter nouns end in alpha, and that alpha is attached to the genitive stem, not the lexical form. So, if you want to write the children taught, you would write hoi paides edidaxon. Notice here you've got that epsilon sigma ending. That's the mark of the nominative plural in the masculine or feminine. Suppose you want to say the knights fell, plural knights, the knights fell. You would write hi. Nuctes epison. Hi, nuctes epison. Notice here that this is not nux with a xi. You've got nuctes, which is the nu, upsilon, kappa, tau of the genitive form. The genitive form ends in omicron sigma, so it would be nuctos, but we've just taken that stem and turned it into nuctes by adding the epsilon sigma of the nominative plural. Here too, you've got paide, not pais, which is the nominative form. The paide of paidos, the omicron sigma drops off and we add the nominative plural ending, epsilon sigma. Now the neuter ending is alpha. And again, it is attached to the genitive singular form of the stem. So for the bodies we're eating, you would have ta, soma, t'a. Remember that the genitive form is somatos. So it's not soma with an a, but it's somat with that a, the genitive singular form. The a drops off, you add the a ending. Similarly, for the genitive plural of the year, you would have ta ete. Yeah, again, it's irregular. It's a funny spelling, and again, you'll see why on page 76 and 77 of Porter. Mercifully, genitive plural forms end in omega nu across the board, so it's really easy to spot them. So to say the wisdom of the children, we would say, hey Sophia, ton paidon. Just as exactly as you would think. Again, you're building on paidos, not on pais, right? Secondly, the brightness of nights is hedoxa ton nukton. Hedoxa ton nukton. And again, you're building on nu upsilon kappa tau nukt, not nu upsilon xi nux. Hey, the joy of the body is hekara ton somaton. And I was speaking of the years, believe it or not, is just plain elegon tone eton. So it's exactly the same ending all the way across the board, that omega nu ending that we've come to know and love for the genitive plural. Dative plural forms in the third declension end in sigma iota and sometimes in sigma iota nu. That is, they have a movable nu, just like the third person singular of the verb. So they end in sigma iota nu, and you have all of the combination issues with sigma. Therefore, your endings are going to look a little different. But they're still based on the genitive singular ending. It's just that whatever the ending of that genitive singular is going to connect and merge with that sigma. So let's look at I gave birth to the child. We're going to have I gave birth, egenesa, tois, and then you're going to have pai. Notice that this is no longer a delta, it's a sigma. But if you go back to chapter 1 and look at how sigmas combine with deltas, you'll find that the delta drops out and the sigma is just taking the place of the delta, and it's perfectly normal and natural and everything is all good. And so you have your sigma iota and the movable new ending of the dative plural. Now how about I stood still for the nights? Plural. Okay, so again we've got tais, because it's feminine, and then you have nuxi. This is not building on the nominative singular, it's actually building on the genitive singular, nu, upsilon, kappa, tau. But the kappa tau has combined with the sigma to create the double consonant c. And so what you have is not so much an ending that's built on the word nux, the nominative singular. It is still built on the genitive singular, but the sigma has combined with other things, and sigmas do that. And we know that because we've looked at the aorist already. Now, the third declension for I gave to the bodies, plural. As you remember, the neuter plural of the article is tois for the dative. And then again, you would have soul, ma, and notice you've got c. Again, the same thing holds with the tau as with the delta. The tau plus the sigma, the tau disappears and the sigma takes its place. And so this is still built off of somat, sigma omega mu alpha tau. But the tau and the sigma have merged, and there you have that sigma. Lastly, apon tois. I want to say I spoke to the years, you'd say apon tois. And here we have etesi. This is one of the first times you actually get to see that the ending for the genitive is actually epsilon sigma. And you have the epsilon sigma merging with the sigma iota nu to form etesi or etesen. And again, more about that on pages 76 and 77 in the Porter book.
For some reason, I haven't been able to fix tonight. The accusative plural part of that video just didn't record, and the reasons I can't fix it are too long to go into. So I'm just going to walk you verbally through the accusative plural. In order to say I'm calling the children, you would end the paidas with an alpha sigma. The accusative plural ends with an alpha sigma. So the sentence would read, parakalun tus paidas, P alpha iota delta alpha sigma, with the alpha sigma as the ending. To say I'm praising the night, you would say, edoxason tas nuktas. Again, alpha sigma ending. And it's really dangerous because we look at the alpha sigma ending and we think either feminine singular genitive or feminine plural accusative. Well, with tas nuktas, it happens to be feminine neuter accusative, but it's third declension. But with tus paidas, it's still accusative plural, but it's masculine because third declension nouns all take the alpha sigma ending, even if they are masculine or feminine, because they're third declension. Obviously, the neuter plural nouns of the third declension take the same form as the nominative plural forms of the third declension, because the neuter accusative and the nominative are going to be the same form as they are with all neuter nouns between now and the time that Jesus comes back. So, to say I betrayed the bodies, plural, you would say paridokata somata, and to say I saw the years, plural, you would say eidon ta ete, just as you would for the singular, for the nominative, sorry. All right, on to Amy.
Amy is generally called a copulative verb. It joins two similar things together. Think of it as a great big equal sign. And what it means is that everything on one side of the equal sign is going to be exactly the same as everything on the other side of the equal sign. What you will find on one side of the equal sign is the nominative case, What you will find on the other side of the equal sign is also the nominative case. You will rarely, if any time, find another case on either side of ami. Then it's going to be the nominative in each case. There are other copulative verbs, but for now, this one is the one we're going to focus on, the verb ami.
What's important right now is to learn the two forms of ami. There are two that we will learn today, an unaugmented form and an augmented form. That is a form without the augment epsilon and a form with the augment epsilon.
Porter introduces ami as having an unaugmented form and an augmented form. An unaugmented form is a form without the augment epsilon at the beginning of the verb. An augmented form is a form with the form of the verb of the letter epsilon at the beginning of the verb. The unaugmented forms of ami are as follows, and you can find these on pages 72 and 71 of Porter. The first one is ami. And ami means I am. So when you hear Jesus say, I am the bread of life, or I am the vine and you are the branches, Jesus is using the verb ami. The second person, you are, singular, is a. Notice that it has an accent. That is to distinguish it from this word a, which means if. So the second person is a with a smooth breathing mark and also an accent. This is one of those places where accent matters. The third person, he, she, or it is, you already have used all in your translations. It is estin or st with a movable nu. Then to say we are, we would say s men. Notice the men ending. It should look really familiar at this point, both from the aorist, samen, and amen, and from the imperfect, amen. That men ending is a good clue that you're in the first person plural and the verb is saying we. Second person plural is esta. Again, notice the te ending, signaling the second person plural, y'all. Finally, you have ac with a movable nu, and that means they are. So the form of the verb ami in the unaugmented are ami, asd, asmen, esta, ac.
The augmented form of ami takes the secondary endings that we've been practicing with the aorist and imperfect tenses, as well as an augment, just like the aorist and imperfect tenses.
The augmented form of the verb ami is as follows. Amen, I was. Ace, which is you were. Ain, which is he, she, it was. We were is amen. Again, you'll notice that men ending that is telling you, oh, we're dealing with we. And then ata, where is that ta ending that's telling you, oh, we're dealing with y'all. Y'all were. And then they were is acing.
So ami is not hard, but it is a very useful and important word. Consider ego ami, or I am, the passages in John. So get to know ami this week. Here are some reminders. Memorize your vocabulary in Chapter 7. We will be using the vocabulary in class on Tuesday. Read Chapter 7 before you come to class. Also remember, there is a vocabulary quiz. It will just be on the vocabulary from Chapter 5 only. Chapter 5 only. Also, you must go to Moodle by Monday night to talk about and respond to this video and raise any questions you might have. You can't make this up, so don't forget to do it. Finally, don't forget to bring your Porter textbook and workbook to class on Tuesday night. I will see you on Tuesday. Kariskai Irene.